25th. Also, don't forget the big Tibetan Freedom Concert this weekend in San Francisco, which we'll be covering live. This Saturday and Sunday, live from San Francisco, it's Fugees, Foo Fighters, Rage Against the Machine, Red Hot Chili Peppers, Smashing Pumpkins, Beastie Boys, Bjork, Sonic Youth, Tribe Called Quest, and more, including us, live at the Tibetan Freedom Concert with twice hourly reports from 3 to 9 p.m. each day, plus two live editions of the Weekend Rock this weekend, Saturday at 3:30 and 7:30, Sunday at 4:30 and 8. Music, the fans, and the cause, the Tibetan Freedom Concert, live from San Francisco to you this Saturday and Sunday.
Hi, I'm Tabitha Soren.
I'm Kurt Loder. This is the Weekend Rock live from San Francisco's Golden Gate Park. No Pearl Jam today, but lots of acts are here for the Tibetan Freedom Concert, a two-day all-star show that today alone will feature the Beastie Boys, who organized it with the Miller Epifund, plus Smashing Pumpkins, Foo Fighters, Tribe Called Quest, and right on stage right now, Mr. Richie Havens.
But of course, music is another big point. That's why many of these people are here. Still to come later on in the day, we've got Smashing Pumpkins, Foo Fighters, a great lineup. Also, the Beastie Boys. And of course, Adam Yauch from the Beastie Boys, instrumental in helping put this concert together. I understand Allison Stewart is backstage with him right now. Allison.
You'd understand, correct, John. I'm backstage in our interview tent, which is really kind of beautiful. We're sitting on some original Tibetan prayer rugs that were got from a couple of curators, a couple of museums. And, of course, I am with Adam Yauch, one of the organizers of today's concert.
Howdy.
It's your big day. It's one thing to play a benefit. It's one thing to be on a benefit record. It's another thing to put on an entire concert. Why a concert, Adam? Why did this seem like a good idea, a good way to get the message across?
Well, I think the main thing that everyone has to realize about the situation, about what's happening, is our own involvement in it and how we fuel the corporations by our spending that are actually helping with the oppression that's going on in China. Mm-hmm. And the main purpose of the concert is just for people to really realize how on a daily basis, every time when we go shopping, when we spend money, that we're actually supporting human rights abuses. And it's just important for everyone to understand that our corporations are making campaign contributions to our elected officials, mm-hmm. In exchange for our elected officials making foreign policy that separates human rights issues from trade issues. And it's already been proven with South Africa and several other places that financial sanctions do have an effect on human rights. So basically, our corporations, just strictly motivated by greed, are moving ahead and trying to make as much money as they can, and our government is going right along with it. Our elected officials are saying, yeah, we'll take your campaign contributions. And so it's crucial for us as individuals, as human beings, and as Americans to demand that our government and our elected officials, and especially President Clinton, take a stand on this stuff. It's disgusting that President Clinton is allowing this to happen, and I think that Clinton isn't even realizing the power that he has to change this. He's not thinking about it. And I think we, as citizens of the United States, need to demand this. And
we also need to educate ourselves. What, if somebody's coming to this concert to see some music, what's a way that they can educate themselves about this issue so that they can write that letter with authority?
Well, for people who are at home watching, I mean, they can look on the website. There's a website to get information, mm-hmm. or they can call the phone number. But I think what's really important is just for everyone to start boycotting everything that's made in China. If we all, like, simultaneously focus on this issue and boycott, it's going to send a powerful message to our corporations and our government and the Chinese government that these human rights abuses are not acceptable. And we just have to remember that when we're spending money, if we're buying things that are made in China, we're actually fueling it. We're helping to continue what's going on there.
Well, if you're not familiar of why this concert is going on, about the Chinese occupation of Tibet, we put together this story so you can get a little sense of what's been going on, the he said, she said of it. China says Tibet's part of that country, Tibet, they want their freedom, and how does the United States and how do you partake in all of this? Watch and take notes. Thanks, Adam. What was your musical highlight of the day, the thing you're going to go back and tell everybody about?
When I got thrown over the crowd, the Beasties, and I got to look at the Beasties 5 feet in front of me.
All right, it was a good time. Sure to have another good time today. Get out on stage behind.
my right now, representing the East Coast hip hop. Of course, hip hop yesterday represented by a couple of bands, including the Beastie Boys, who helped organize this whole thing. Here's a taste of the Beastie doing So What You Want.
Well, they call me Mike T, and I'm a married man. I'd like a school named G. Well, I'm a metropolitan. Scream in your holler, but my Chevy Impala. This one is getting wet, I'll rent the ring around your collar. Like a tree in my flowing without no stopping. Sweeter than the cherry pie, ready whip topping. From fight to fight, kicking it wall to wall. Well, I'll be going out to people like a cowboy.
Beastie Boys are instrumental in organizing this concert, and certainly they're able to give yesterday's throng of 50,000 or so mightily entertained.
Meet Aaron Potts, 24-year-old director and co-founder of the Milarepa Fund.
How did the whole Milarepa Fund start?
I had met Adam Yauch from the Beastie Boys when I was living in Nepal in 1992, and we just became friends. He was really, really interested and excited about Tibetan culture. He asked me if I would do it, and I said, if we're going to do it, let's do it right. Let's start an organization.
And so in May 1994, Adam and Aaron established the Milarepa Fund, a nonprofit organization working to spread the word about China's campaign to wipe Tibetan Buddhist culture off their map.
If we're going to affect change, we have to use our cultural tools, and that's music, and that's the internet, and that's TV.
And this weekend, it's a concert.
The main reason that we're doing the concert is to raise awareness about Tibet, to let people find out about the Chinese occupation, because so few people are aware of it.
All the performers are really excited about it.
In addition to putting together the entire Tibetan Freedom Concert, the Milarepa Fund is also working on a couple of public service announcements and an educational documentary, all here in this teeny office run by a bunch of 20-somethings.
Guys, when did you become aware of the situation in Tibet with China?
Probably about, 3 years ago, when we played Lollapalooza with the Beastie Boys and the Tibetan monks.
San Francisco edition of the Weekend Rock, the Beastie Boys, live.
We're going to be back with more from the Tibetan Freedom Concert, but right now, here are the Beastie Boys on stage.
I was my man, the Beast.
Welcome back to the Weekend Rock, live from the Tibetan Freedom Concert in San Francisco's Golden Gate Park.
Just now on stage are the Beastie Boys. They're in between songs right now. Their stage is crowded with people. There's people as far as the eye can see in front of us too, Kurt.
There are. There are millions of them. Beastie Boys are sounding really great. Hope they never, ever go away again. They just, we miss them when they're gone.
Well, check them out.
The Beastie Boys ain't coming home. They coming home. They coming home. They coming home. Sing it! They coming home. Oh, they coming home.
punk rock rappers, the Beastie Boys, there with a little help from Biz Markie. That's about all the time we have for today, but we will be back tomorrow for day two of the Tibetan Freedom Concert.
Unless, of course, we just levitate right here with the Beastie Boys. Tomorrow, the Fugees, Rage Against the Machine, Red Hot Chili Peppers, Björk, Deck, and Sonic Youth, all slated to play, and we'll be here throughout the twice-hourly live reports.
Plus two more live editions of The Week in Rock at 4:30 and 8 p.m.
To be here.
You don't want to miss it.
We're doing this song now. It's called Believe Me. Thanks to everyone coming down. And I'll say, let's do this.
That's it from San Francisco's Golden Gate Park. Week in Rock will return to our warm, cozy New York City studio next week. We leave you now with more Beastie Boys.
We'll see you then. Quick break, and here's a little more of the Beastie's performance yesterday.
So you see there, the Miller Epiphone in this concert would not exist without the Beastie Boys, whose Adam Yauch and Mike D spent a few moments earlier today with John Norris in the interview tent.
I think it's important for everyone to understand that what's happening is our corporations are putting pressure on our government and making campaign contributions to our elected officials to separate human rights issues from trade issues. And it can't go on. And we have to send a message to those corporations and to our elected officials that that's not acceptable. And when we look at TV commercials, when we see those, we have to think about what those corporations are sending us. That when you see a commercial on TV, it's not just some nice little product. Those companies, you have to think about what those companies represent and what they're doing with that money that they're making. Because by buying stuff from those companies, often we're actually fueling the human rights abuses that are going on around the world.
That was John with an interview with Adam Yauch.
Action aplenty on stage and out in the crowd, of course. As for the backstage activity, Serena Altschul got a personally guided tour from Beastie Boy Mike D.
So you're going to take us on a tour backstage?
Yeah, I'm going to show you some of the techniques back here, some of the methods.
Backstage driving?
Yeah, exactly. Now we're heading into the main sort of backstage corral area. This is behind the stage.
Where are we going?
Now we're gonna go up to the viewing area. All right, now Buddy Guy is performing.
What a view!
Okay. I'm on the mic right now. I'm doing a blow by blow tour.
A behind the scenes peek at what goes on backstage.
All right, now here we are heading back into the artist compound.
Ooh.
Hanging out with the artists.
And each of these tents is like a...
Yeah, this is each an individual dressing room for the different bands performing today.
Fugees.
Got De La Soul, Fugees.
Peppers.
Chili Peppers.
Bjork.
Over there, Bjork.
Excellent. Do you know anybody here we can peek in and say hi to?
Well, I don't want to interrupt anyone,
yeah.
You know. Well, there's Beck over there. Oh, my God. Oh, no. Oh, look at that.
So you know what this is?
This is the behind-the-scenes TV truck.
So this is where all the chaos happens.
All right.
What'd you think of Yoko?
Good show.
Yoko
rocks. I think she woke
a lot of people up, I think.
That's what I'm saying. She catches people unexpectedly.
Yeah.
Okay, look out. Get out of the way. Okay, look out. Okay.
What about, like, the fans, like, people out in the... You know, in the field, like watching the whole show, and they're like, you know, they have no clue. They think it's like the most glamorous thing in the world being backstage, but it looks pretty much like, you know, a construction zone. You know, there's nothing really glam going on.
Well, in that sense, being back here backstage is what you make it.
Last weekend's Tibetan Freedom Concert in San Francisco's Golden Gate Park was an impassioned protest prompted by Buddhist Beastie Boys bassist Adam Yauch against the ongoing 50-year occupation of the pacifist country of Tibet by the faceless dictators of communist China, which is exterminating Tibetan culture and the Tibetan people, too. The concert, produced by the Miller Epiphone and Bill Graham Presents, also featured top form performances by Smashing Pumpkins, De La Soul, and Foo Fighters, lovable loony interludes with Beck Hansen, Biz Markie, and the delirious Chibo Motto, with Sean Lennon on Earthquake bass, and a thunderous turn by Rage Against the Machine. Here's a wrap-up.
The world is a vampire!
I'm glad it's for a good cause, and I'm glad that my money went towards that, but I'm here to see the Beastie Boys.
Get the boys, get the boys, get the boys, get the boys, we in the joy. Get the boys, get the boys, get the boys, get the boys, we in the joy. Hey, ooh, ah, ooh, ooh, ah.
The Tibetan Freedom Concert attracted more than 100,000 fans, making it the biggest U.S. benefit show since Live Aid in 1985. It was followed on Monday by a nonviolent protest outside the Chinese consulate in San Francisco by some 300 people, among them Perry Farrell and Chili Peppers bassist Flea. With U.S. corporations currently flocking to make a killing in the booming Chinese market, more and more of our consumer goods are being made in that country, in many cases reportedly by slave labor. Those who find this objectionable should check out all product labels for country of origin.
Foreign Policy Wake Up Call.
We'll be right back with Perry Farrell and Porno for Pyros on their Supernatural recording sessions. Beastie Boy Adam Yauch taking his fight for Tibet to Capitol Hill and a musical response to the wave of Southern church burning. Do stay with us.
And finally, Beastie Boy and Tibetan Freedom Concert organizer Adam Yauch spent Tuesday and Wednesday in Washington, D.C., lobbying politicians to oppose President Clinton's renewal of China's most favored nation trading status. The anti-MFN measure, however, died in a Thursday vote.
Welcome back to the Weekend Rock. Finally, in the year ahead, we're going to be bringing you a new series of reports called From the Vaults, digging out vintage moments from the channel's sprawling tape archives. To start off, we put in a request for some highlights from MTV New Year's parties of the past.
Are you ready to lose all respect for yourself as a human being tonight?
All right! Kick it!
I'm not embarrassed.
What's that noise? Why? Oh, now you're just jealous. It's the Beastie Boys.
Try and top that, Dick Clark.
No! Flee to Brooklyn! No! Flee to Brooklyn! 18 life is the thought of this man. It's the end. You don't like my man.
The Tibet Freedom Concerts have a serious purpose, of course, and they also mark a rare case in which musical activism has helped bring an actual change in political reality.
Just go back to the